DeAndre Jordan. If only I was as bold as Raoul. The other day, he left one of his paintings out on Mr. Ward's desk where anybody could see it, which was the point. He sometimes works at Mr. Ward's desk during lunch. The wet paintbrushes sticking up out of the jar are always a sign that he's been at it again. So, of course, anybody who glances over in that direction will be tempted to stop by and look. This particular painting was rough, but anyone could tell it was Raoul. A self-portrait. He'll probably hang it in class. Back in September, Mr. Ward covered two of the classroom walls with black construction paper and then scattered paper frames up and down the walls, each one a different size and color. Now half the room looks like sort of an art gallery, which was the idea. We're supposed to use the paper frames for our work. Whether we put up poems or photographs or even paintings is up to us, so long as the work is ours and we can tie it in with our study of the Harlem Renaissance. I guess Raoul's self-portrait fits, since we've been talking a lot about identity. He'll probably put it up next to his poem. You should have seen him hang that thing. You'd think he was handling a million-dollar masterpiece the way he took his time, placing it just so. If you look close, you can see the smudges where he erased a word or two and rewrote it. Mr. Ward must be in shock. He can never get Raoul to rewrite a lick of homework or anything else. And don't even talk to him about checking his spelling. He'll launch into a tirade on you in a minute. What? He'll snap. You think Puerto Ricans can't spell? Forget it. Anyway, I dare you to find one misspelled word in that poem of his. Maybe it's a visual thing. Maybe he wants his poem to look as good as a self-portrait. And it is good. I've never tried doing a self-portrait, but why not? I could maybe do one in charcoal. I like drawing faces in charcoal. I've been drawing since I can't remember when. Not that anyone here knows that, except Tanisha. And she found out by accident when she came to my house to study once and saw a couple of drawings hanging in my room. Mom loves my watercolors, and she hung one in the living room, but it isn't signed. Nobody ever mentions it, especially not my father. He's not too wild about my art. Mostly he's disappointed. First off, that I wasn't born a boy, and second, that I won't play ball like one. I'm 6 feet tall, almost as tall as he, and he figures the height is wasted on me since I don't share his dreams of me going to the WNBA. I keep telling him not to hold his breath. I hate always being the tallest girl in school. Everybody expects me to play basketball, so they pick me for their team, throw me the ball, and wait for me to shoot. Big mistake. I fumble it every time. Then they have the nerve to get mad at me, like I did it on purpose. But basketball is not my game. I have no game. I'm an artist, like Raoul. The difference is, I don't tell anybody. I refuse to give them the new reasons to laugh at me. The Jolly Green Giant jokes are bad enough. Yeah, it's definitely time to try a self-portrait. I think I'll paint myself in front of an easel, with a basketball jersey sticking up out of the trash. Then I could hang it in Mr. Ward's class. See if anybody notices. Open Mic If by DeAndre Jordan. If I stood on tiptoe, reached up and sculpted mountains from clouds, would you laugh out loud? If I dipped my brush in starlight, painted a ribbon of night on your windowsill, would you still laugh? If I drew you adrift in a pen and ink sea in a raging storm, would you laugh at me? If I planted watercolor roses in your garden, would you laugh then? Or would you breathe deep to sample their scent? I wonder. Tyrone. If the sister read any faster, I'd be looking for a Supergirl cape. Talk about nervous. DeAndra's hands were shaking the whole time she was holding that poem. She sure spooks easy for somebody so tall. Yo, I said, take a deep breath. Ain't nobody going to hurt you here. She smiled a little and tried to slow down, but I swear that girl burned rubber getting back to her seat when she was through. I guess she's not exactly used to the limelight. She's got plenty of company. Four more kids read their poetry for the first time today. They were shaking in their boots, but it was all good. I only had to tell one of them to loosen up. Guess you could call that progress.